Well, you know, the vice president is a very poor advocate for the position he's now taking, because in 1992, when he was chairman of the Judiciary Committee, he said to the Bush 41 administration, if a vacancy occurs in the middle of a presidential election, we won't fill it. So we're applying the Biden rule. There's nothing particularly pro or con about Judge Merrick. It's just that right in the middle of a presidential election, the outgoing president doesn't get to have a nominee like this considered. And that's been the history. It's been 80 years since a vacancy created in presidential election year was filled. You have to go back to 1888. You remember Grover Cleveland?
Personally, no.
The last time a vacancy created in a presidential election year when you had the Senate controlled by the opposite party was confirmed. So this has been the tradition. There's nothing unusual about it. I don't blame the president for trying, but this vacancy is going to be filled by the person elected by the American people in November.
What about the counter to the argument? Because the others would say, you know, if you're saying let the American people choose have a voice in this, some would say, well, the American people do have a voice through the president whom they've elected twice.
Right. And the American people had a voice in 2014 when they elected a Republican Senate. And under the Constitution, this is not the president's sole responsibility. He nominates, but the Senate has to decide whether to confirm. And in the most recent election, the American people had an opportunity to speak, and they made me the majority leader and elected the Republicans to be in the majority in the Senate. So that's the most recent election if you want to look at elections.
Is there any scenario, Senator, in which you can see you and or the Senate changing your mind on simply hearing Judge Merrick?
No.
Very decisive.
Yeah.
I expected some follow-up. Why is that? Is it just based on the reason that you...
Well, we're not going to consider this nominee because it's the nomination is going to be made, and the Senate will ultimately confirm a nomination made by the person who's being elected in November to take office in January.
What do you say to voters who just disagree and don't really understand why the Senate won't have confirmation hearings? Because a lot of people just say, oh, it's just back and forth, D.C. bickering and obstructionism.
Well, I'm sorry people feel that way, but under the Constitution, the President and the Senate have joint responsibility in filling a vacancy on the Supreme Court. When the American people elected a Republican majority in 2014, they were not saying, confirm a liberal nominee by Barack Obama to turn the court to the left for the next generation.